All right, now let's take this example to the next level. Instead of displaying a simple title field, we want to display the list of courses. So first we need a field to hold the list of courses. So courses, we set this to an array with three items, course 1, course 2, and course 3. Now this is a simplified example. In a real world application, instead of simple strings here, we would have objects. But don't worry, we're going to get there. Now, we want to display these in our template. How should we do that? First, we need to change this single quote to the backtick character. So delete, backtick. Backtick is the character before number 1 on your keyboard. Let me change this as well. Now, the benefit of using the backtick is that we can break up this template into multiple lines and make it more readable. So I want to put this h2 here, and below that I want to add a ul and a bunch of list item elements like this. Now we want to repeat this li for each course. Now for that we need to use one of the Angular building blocks called directive. We use directives to manipulate the DOM. We can use them to add a DOM element or remove an existing DOM element or change the class of a DOM element or its style, and so on. So here, we're going to use a special directive called ng4. We use it like an attribute in HTML. So we set it to a string, and here we're going to write some expression. Now, before going any further, we should prefix this attribute with an asterisk. This is a special syntax in Angular. So whenever you're using a directive that modifies the structure of a DOM, you should prefix that directive with an asterisk. In case you're curious about the reason, I have covered it later in the section about directives. So for now, just remember, whenever you are using a directive that modifies the structure of the DOM by adding or removing an element, you need to prefix that with an asterisk. Now here we want to write an expression similar to what we write in for each blocks. So let course of courses. What does this mean? With the let keyword, we are defining a variable. So the name of our variable is course. This is like a loop variable in JavaScript. Of is a special keyword, and courses is the field in this class that we are iterating over. So when Angular sees this expression, it's going to iterate over the courses field. And in each iteration, this course variable will hold the value of one course at a time. Now, inside this list item, we want to display this course. So once again, we use string interpolation, double curly braces, and add this course variable here. Let's look at the result. Save. Back in the browser, and here we have the list of our courses. Beautiful. Now, in most real-world applications, we get these courses from the server. And for that, we need to use another building block of Angular called a service. And that's the topic for the next lecture.